Everybody and welcome to the channel. I'm actually making a video from the airport. My flight is delayed, so I thought I would take this opportunity to make a video. This video is going to be about request for deferrals. So if you have been asked to come into an interview with CBSA and asked to leave Canada, typically it's usually in a few weeks. CBSA will ask you to come with proof of purchase of your plane tickets in order for you to leave Canada. Once you bring in your plane tickets, you will receive a direction to report, which will have the date and time of your scheduled flight from Canada to your country of citizenship. If you want to stay longer, what you could do is submit a request for deferral. So this is an application, essentially it's a cover letter. If we prepare it as lawyers, it's called a legal submission letter. Which outlines the reasons why you believe that you should be granted more time in Canada, and you could attach supporting documentation. So for example, if you have filed a humanitarian and compassionate application or a spousal sponsorship application and they're in process and it's been a little while, you could put that as an argument to want to stay in Canada until a decision is made. Other reasons can be if you have a medical condition which requires you to stay in Canada to be followed by specialists or experts. If you have children and they're in school and it's in the middle of the school year, that's a very strong reason to want to stay in Canada so they could complete their schooling in order not to have negative consequences on your children's education. So there could be a number of different factors. So you would outline those reasons in detail in the letter, and you would also include the supporting documents. You could submit it by mail to the CBSA office, or you could fax it if it's less than 20 pages to the deferral officer. What's going to happen is an officer is going to receive that, will give it to the deferral unit, and you will then get a decision a little while later if it's approved or refused. These days, typically CBSA tends to give decisions a few days before, sometimes even one day before. This is quite inconvenient because you're in limbo, right? You have to leave, you put in a request to stay longer. If you have an apartment, what do you do with your rental agreement? If you own a house, what do you do with your house? If you have a car, your children are in school. So it's quite difficult actually because you don't know what's going to happen. So you have to be prepared. You have to be prepared for the worst, which is that you have to show up for your removal from Canada. And if you don't show up, if you have a direction to report and you do not show up, then CBSA will issue a warrant for your arrest with the RCMP, and that's not going to be good for your immigration history, and they're going to be looking for you. So requests for deferrals are, I would suggest, if you're in a difficult situation, to get an immigration lawyer to help you out, because there's a specific way to prepare them, to prepare strong argumentation. The last resort, if your request for deferral is denied, is you can file what's called a motion for a stay at the federal court. But this is really at our office, we really only do them if we feel that there's going to be irreparable harm to the people being removed. It's not in every case that we do that. It's quite a complex application. It's an urgent application at the federal court. It requires a lot of preparation. And sometimes it's very difficult to do because CBSA doesn't give lawyers enough time to prepare properly. So if you have received instructions from CBSA to buy your plane tickets in a few months or a few weeks, or if you feel that that might be coming and you have good reasons to want to stay a little bit longer, requests for deferrals are not meant to get a positive decision on an application or for you to stay forever in Canada. It's really a temporary deferral of your removal. So it's typically a few months, 6 months, or a year until something happens that allows you to then leave, or you're waiting for a decision. So if you are in that situation, you can contact our office and we can schedule a consultation with you to see what's your story, what's the situation, and if it's worth it to do a request for deferral, or perhaps it's not and it's best to take the money that you have that you would maybe hire a lawyer for to go home and build a new life for yourself. It's quite difficult situations, but we're very familiar with those situations, so we could give you the best advice. Thank you, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact us.